Pat here. I'm just putting together a quick video as a follow-up to my foam roller workshop and to make sure you're all using the correct technique when using the roller for spinal and postural health. Okay, so it's really straightforward. We start off with the roller around the height of our ribs. Support your neck, elbows come together to splay the shoulder blades that will allow the roller to really get into the spine and surrounding muscles. And we simply lift ourselves up and roll from the lower ribs up to the base of the neck, no further. We're going to spend 20 to 30 seconds doing that, looking for where the tight spots are, getting some blood flowing to the muscles and generally loosening things up and preparing them for the stretch that's coming now. So once we've done that and you're comfortable on the roller, we simply place it just below the shoulder blades is a good spot to start, or a bit lower if you can handle it. We lift ourselves up at the bottom here. The arms and head come over and down to touch the ground, and then we drop our bottom to the ground as well. Okay, so that puts a really big stretch through this part of your back, and that's the fulcrum, that's where you should be feeling. We'd be aiming to hold that for a good 30 to 40 seconds. You might want to start off shorter in the beginning while you're getting used to it. And if that's a lot of pressure on your neck and your spine, simply place a couple of pillows under your head so you don't go back quite as far, okay? Once we've done that, we just move up an inch or two to the next part of the spine, and the same again. Head down, wrist down, drop your bottom. Enjoy the stretch. So you'll feel that's really powerful in opening up that chest and undoing all of this yucky desk posture we're becoming accustomed to these days. You'll see I'm always supporting my neck when I go to sit up, okay? It's really important we don't strain our necks too much. So that's taking care of the forward and backwards motion within the spine. Now we're also going to take care of some rotation, and that really gets rid of a lot of stiffness as well. So same scenario, same location for the roller. Support the head, elbows together, and we're just going to do gentle side-to-side motion, moving up and down the spine. So for me, this turning to the left at that spot is quite tight compared to the rest, so I'll just spend a bit of extra time on those joints there in particular, and I might even lift myself up and roll them, biasing my weight onto that side. Okay, so find out where your tight spots are and work through those with rotation. Okay, so that's really the crux of it with using the roller. When you get a bit more advanced and you want a more specific contact, you can use a couple of balls that are either taped together or put in a bag like these ones. Okay, so you get a much more precise contact with the spine using these. A bit more advanced, I would say. So it's the same concept, forward and back, and rotation is what we want to take care of. So you place those between the shoulder blades, nice and level, lean back over them. Once they feel straight, simply arms go over and drop down towards the ground, perhaps 10 or 20 times. Then we point at the ceiling and gentle rotation side to side to take the rotation out of the spine. Hold your head, move up to the next vertebra an inch, and we do the same again. So by using the roller and the balls for just a few minutes a day, you'll make sure your spine stays nice and supple. You'll get rid of some of that computer desk posture. It'll really help with your adjustments, holding, and overall health of your spine. You'll feel immediately much easier to breathe. You'll be standing taller and less pain in the muscles. So it's a bit of a no-brainer. Make sure you do it. Look, try and do it daily in the beginning. If you get down to maintenance of 3 times a week, you know, 4 or 5 minutes each day, that's great. You'll do really well for it. Okay, hope you enjoyed it.